and go
you
with
still,
that.
But you can still make fun of it. Like, yeah. I do jokes like that, and it hurts people's feelings. But there is, like, people who take themselves very seriously and stuff that is ridiculous, or it seems ridiculous, or that you don't take seriously, it's just hard not to... You want to mock them right to their face so they kind of lighten the fuck up. It's like, you're not that serious.
For me, it's not mocking them. It's more like, we should share in that this is a little so silly. Yeah. You know, like, we should look at each other. Like, you know when something weird's happening, like on a plane or an airport? I always look for someone else... Right. Gets it. Like, Dave Chappelle had that bit about the other black guy on a plane, one of my favorite bits ever, because they know they're not going to get taken hostage. It's like one of the, they like wink at each other, like, we're okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I like when something weird happens, you know, you always look, like, that was how I knew who my friends were all.
Right.
When something strange or bizarre or funny would go down, the person you can share eye contact with and go, like, this is fucking crazy, right? You know?
Yeah.
And so I love that when you're with a stranger, or you're in a weird place, like an airport, this weird, like, stop on life, and you get to share that moment with someone, like, two people screaming at each other, and you see a person, and you're like, right? Like, you're like, we're all noticing this, you know?
Well, there was a woman on a plane recently that was doing yoga. Like, she got up and started doing yoga in the aisle. And I understand you're stretching and sitting down a lot, but it's...
You're in a plane.
And it's a very fine line between looking around and acknowledging.
Do you say something, or what's your deal? Like, how do you handle that kind of scenario?
Well, I really try to not say something first, because my mouth has gotten me into trouble more so than not. Because you're natural, because there's a fine line between being funny and being a fucking bird.
Right.
You know, there's a fine line between looking for people who see what you're seeing and going, like, that's really dumb, you know, and just being nice about it. So I try not to be. I'll just tweet that shit. But in the situation, I take away the odds.
I find your Twitter on your TV show, your Twitter
The troll thing.
I have a lot of friends, or I have some friends who are friends in some way or another, and I find it really interesting when they look at themselves on Twitter, or they look what people are saying or something.
Yeah.
I really don't do that. I think it's, like, really bad for you.
It is bad for you. It's horrible.
But I find it interesting that you do let it... You do it because you know it makes you feel bummed out or something.
I really have a hard time with that every time. Because I'll fight, you know, I'll have really weird insult fights with friends, you know, like me and Michael Ian Black or Dave Anthony or whatever. Right. But then I'll engage with a troll. And I'm just starting...
I like that episode where you went and found that kid. Yeah. To talk shit about you.
This is some poor nerd kid who's angry. But I have a problem with that. The difference between feeling, you know, that warmth of making someone laugh, but also feeling the warmth of, like, anger. It's tricky for me. Like, you know, they're both feelings, and they're tangible. One is not good. The other is good. But I still have a sort of compulsion towards that. Rage is very relieving.
Is it for you?
Sometimes. I mean, I don't feel good right after, but when you're going, shut the fuck up, you know what I mean? You're like, after you do that, you're sort of like, okay, I'm sorry. You know, you're like, all right, you're crying. I feel that that's out of me, but clearly I've done some damage here.
I'm glad you find that enjoyment.
No, it's not enjoyment. It's something I have to stop. You don't get angry.
You're aware.
Yeah.
You're aware. That's the good part.
That's right. No, I'm getting a lot better. Yeah, I find that if you want to keep women in your life, you might want to turn that down a little bit. You don't find yourself angry?
In general?
Yeah.
I mean, of course I get angry sometimes, but...
What are the things that, like...
I would be angry if someone was, like, mean to someone close to me.
Yeah.
Or, you know, if I really cared about something creatively and... Not anger. I actually wouldn't even call it anger. I would just call it, like, protectiveness.
Right.
Probably in general.
Yeah, and frustration.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but I would really, like, if I love someone and someone's mean to them or something, that would really bum me out. And, that would bum me out.
So it's usually a friend or family-based sort of thing?
It's not even anger as much as I would just get, like, bummed that they were sad, you know? I don't know.
But you've never had cause to go, like, shut the fuck up, you asshole.
I don't know if shut the fuck up is... ever come out of my mouth towards someone. It's like I've just been watching The Sopranos, and I literally just finished. I know it's weird. It actually is weird.
You watched them all? I envy you. I'd love to watch them all.
I watched it when it was on. And it's weird to I have to I didn't mean to bring this up, but since I did, I really am, like, heartbroken that James Gandolfini passed away. And it really is I got to meet him a couple times.
Yeah.
This isn't what this is about.
Yeah.
Just he was the nicest guy.
Yeah.
So I'm really heartbroken about that.
Yeah.
And I happened to be on season 5 re-watching it just as a, because I love it so much.
Right.
When he passed away.
Yeah.
And I've been watching it, and one of the things I noticed a lot about it is how people talk to each other in the show.
Yeah.
In regards to what you were just talking
about,
you say, like, shut the fuck up, just like your wife or something.
Yeah.
And then the next day you're somehow speaking again. Like, I didn't grow up in a household like that. And so to me, it's very fascinating to watch.
You didn't grow up in a mafia household?
No. My dad's Gumara was, no, I'm just kidding.
An idea he had.
Yeah, it was definitely like in his head.
No, he was great, and it was shocking, you know, because like when somebody he was that much of a force of fucking nature just gone, it's like what? It's like a
might be the greatest like character ever.
It is, and one of the greatest shows ever. I mean, I would love to start watching that again.
And because we're on a comedy show, it's super fucking funny.
It is. There's definitely a lot of hilarious stuff.
Laugh out loud, hysterical funny. Whenever something, I noticed it this time around, not to like just make this about The Sopranos or whatever, but like I noticed this thing that they do so brilliantly is whenever someone is going through a modern social problem, they go to Satriel's in the back room and all the guys who are in the century before, like cavemen, try and work out how they feel about it. And it's always the most brilliant comedy scene because it'll be like, whether it's therapy or suicide or being gay or whatever it is, and you have these cavemen trying to really work out like what they feel about it, and if they're able to shift perspective in some way into the next century.
Like Pat Cooper on the therapy thing, where he's like, you know, what are you doing?
My favorite scene in The Sopranos, and one of my favorite things I think, is when Meadow's boyfriend, Finn, had seen Vito giving a blowjob to the security guard, and Tony brings him in to tell all the guys what he saw.
Yeah.
And he's like, and they're all sitting there and they're all trying to digest this. And he goes, so Polly, I think, goes like, so he's getting a blowjob from the security guard. And then the boyfriend, who's totally innocent, goes, no, it was the other way around. And they all explode like, oh, and it's like, he's fucking dead, you know, like that. Like him getting a blowjob was maybe, they were going to maybe be able to work that out.